In this video, I'd like to do a product review of the GoTenna Mesh. This is an off-grid text and locator communicator. This device pairs with your smartphone, if you have the app on there, and allows you to do off-grid communication with anyone else that happens to have one of the GoTenna Meshes. So if you want to communicate with someone across town, theoretically, you could use your GoTenna Mesh, they could have their mesh, and you could pass messages to each other. Now, this has a limited range. So the cool thing about the GoTenna Mesh is that it relies on mesh networking. So if you have a bunch of other people in between you and your friend, these little ones could act as relays for your message. So you could say, hey, are you okay? And it could bounce from one node to the next, all the way to get to your friend across town. So it's really cool technology. You're able to create your own pop-up grid. So there's a lot to cover for this video. Let's just get right down to it. This is a review of the GoTenna Mesh. So you can purchase the GoTenna Mesh online for around $180 on average, although oftentimes it does go on sale. That comes with two of the GoTenna Meshes in addition to the USB charging cables. Let's go over a few of the details with regard to the GoTenna Mesh. So it has a free GoTenna app that includes detailed offline maps for any region of the world. It's USB rechargeable and it has a 24-hour battery life per charge. It's compatible with iOS and Android devices, and it uses Bluetooth LE, which is Bluetooth Low Energy, to pair with your smartphone. So again, it's rechargeable. The dimensions are 4.2 inches by 1.3 inch by 0.9 inches, and it weighs around 1.7 ounces. So GoTenna was kind enough to send me a pair of the GoTenna Meshes for testing purposes, but I felt that I really needed to test the node relays. So I purchased a few other GoTenna Meshes online, such as on eBay, and then I also found it on sale one day. So I have a total of 6 devices to use for this video. One of the primary reasons that the GoTenna Mesh is very appealing is that you could purchase and operate these without having to get an FCC license. So you don't need to get your ham radio technician's license, which could be very beneficial if you're doing some prepping for your family. For example, if your 70-year-old grandmother or mother doesn't want to go get her technician's license, you could get her one of these. As long as she has a smartphone, she'd be able to pair it and use it in an emergency situation. So it's beneficial for people that don't want to go that extra mile to get a more efficient communication setup. So again, that's one of the main perks of the GoTenna Mesh. You don't need an FCC license. I wanted to do a quick little background information with regard to my dealings with GoTenna. So I first learned about this device online about several years back, and then I saw a lot of these reviews start popping up on YouTube from feller prepper YouTube channel. So I saw reviews from Living Survival, Rogue Preparedness, and all of them weren't really happy with their original version of the GoTenna. It was a much longer device and it came in a pair, and they just felt that the range limitation didn't really warrant the cost of it. But now we have the GoTenna Mesh. I felt that those original Gen 1 reviews, they really wanted to include this in their bug out bags, but they just couldn't justify it. Around that time, Survival Tech Nord, aka OH8STN, created a really great video with regard to the original GoTenna device. Link in the description. So Survival Tech Nord went into great detail with regard to the GoTenna device. It's basically a little MERS radio, or a multi-use radio service. It operated in the 151 to 154 megahertz range. It's slightly better range than the cheap FRS radios that you could get at Walmart, for example. But in an urban environment, Survival Tech Nord anticipated you probably get around 600 to 800 yards range. He felt that it was not good for critical or life-saving situations, just for localized scenarios. So it was not a long-range communicator. So at that point, I decided to hold off from purchasing that original version of the GoTenna. Several years later, I watched a really great video by Ham Radio Crash Course that was titled GoTenna Mesh Review, The Future of the Internet. And it was a really fascinating video that got me interested again in the GoTenna. Here's a brief rundown of what was covered in that video. Again, link in the description. He goes into more technical detail, saying that it's very similar to APRS, so APRS squawking out packets. What I really liked about Ham Radio Crash Course's video that piqued my interest again in the GoTenna was how he talked about it from a philosophical standpoint, the GoTenna Mesh. He says this is kind of the way we as a people are going. He talks about it being the sweet spot of anti-Big Brother and net neutrality. So some of the things he listed off is that it's encrypted communication, so no one can listen in on conversations. So it's pretty secure encryption, which you could use blockchain networks for Bitcoin transactions, which is pretty clever. And he discussed the mods that people are doing to it. So after watching this video, it piqued my interest again in the GoTenna Mesh. So the GoTenna Mesh allows you to create your own private network to relay text and other messages with your cell phone. Messages could be transmitted farther than the original GoTenna thanks to mesh technology that expands your reach beyond the point-to-point range. Unlike the original GoTenna, which is limited to person-to-person communication, the mesh allows you to operate across an entire network consisting of everyone who owns the device. To achieve this, the mesh operates on the 902 to 928 megahertz band in North America, as opposed to the original, which uses multi-use radio service, or MERS. All messages are encrypted end-to-end, and you could choose whether your messages are reaching a particular individual, group of people, or all mesh users nearby. Someone serving as a relay won't be able to read your messages. Now let me show you how you can use the GoTenna Mesh device, how to use the app, and how some of the charging and connectivity works. You can easily see if your GoTenna Mesh device is already paired to a smartphone or is in relay mode. So with the device off, if you just do a single tap of the power button, it's going to blink once, it's going to let me know that it's already paired. If it's in relay mode, when you press it once, it's going to blink three times and then turn off, and that lets you know that the device is in relay mode. So the device has a little plastic ribbon that wraps around it to allow you to attach it to your backpack or maybe to a belt clip or something like that. It has a small little plastic cover over the USB port. It's a USB micro port. And then you have a button that's located right next to it for turning on and also to use for pairing. In the smartphone app, it'll show who the user is. It'll give your phone number at the top, which I'm not going to list. It'll tell you the battery charge of the GoTenna Mesh that's connected to the app, and it also has multiple sections. You have a section for chats, location, contacts, relay mode, settings, frequently asked questions, and send feedback. I'm not going to go into too much detail for all these because I don't want you to see all of my contacts, but we'll just do a basic rundown of these particular features. If you go to settings, you could configure things like your profile and emergency settings. You could also pair and unpair a GoTenna device. Let's walk through how to pair a device. Again, you're going to want to have Bluetooth enabled on your smartphone device. So just go to settings and then pair GoTenna. You want to put the GoTenna Mesh device in pairing mode. Turn on the GoTenna Mesh device by long pressing on the power button. When you turn it on and if it's repeatedly blinking, that means that it's in pairing mode and it's looking for a device to pair to. So from the app, just select Pair GoTenna. A little pop-up will come and you just want to say what type of device you have. So I'm going to select GoTenna Mesh and then it's going to connect to the GoTenna Mesh device. It'll take a few seconds, but it's a fairly easy setup for pairing to a device. At this point, you're able to use the GoTenna Mesh device to communicate with another GoTenna Mesh. So you could select chat and then send off a message to a GoTenna Mesh device. When you select the little button on the bottom right-hand corner, it gives you multiple options for shout chat, group chat, and one-on-one chat. For this video, I'm going to be doing a lot of one-on-one chat. So again, the GoTenna Mesh is operating in the 900 megahertz spectrum. So basically this is line of sight communication. So the two GoTenna Meshes basically have to see each other to be able to communicate with each other. If there's a large object in between those two devices, say a mountain or a building or a house or a large hill in town, it's going to have a hard time passing that message to the other device because it doesn't see the other device. That's where the mesh network comes in. If you could have another node that's located high, maybe on top of a building, top of a mountain, on top of a large tree, it could help pass that message from one device down to the other device to get around that obstacle. Now let's show you some field testing of the GoTenna Mesh in an urban environment. Let's get started.
So I conducted some testing of the GoTenna Mesh in downtown Seattle to see how well it performed with buildings around. I parked my vehicle on Vine Street between 4th and 5th Avenue. I then made my way to downtown Seattle by 5th Avenue to run a couple of errands. On the way back from errands, I was checking to see how far away I could communicate to the GoTenna Mesh. Now, since my vehicle was parked on Vine Street, it was technically around a corner, so there was a building blocking the signal, so this was going to impact the distance. I conducted my first test on 5th and Blanchard, so that's four city blocks from where my vehicle was parked. I was not able to send a text message from this distance of around 0.3 miles. I moved up one more city block, so three blocks away from my vehicle on 5th and Bell Street, and even at this distance, I wasn't able to send a text message. I moved up to 5th and Battery, so two city blocks away from the vehicle. And at this distance, I was able to send a text message. Moving up to 5th and Wall Street, I sent another text message, so one block away, and of course, it made it through just fine. So since my vehicle was around a building, I wanted to retest with just a straight shot. So then I parked my vehicle right on 5th Avenue and repeated the test. With just a straight shot, I was able to send a text message to the vehicle from 5th and Lenora, so that's five city blocks away from the GoTenna Mesh, or 0.4 miles. I conducted this test scenario again, but this time in a residential neighborhood, so there were no buildings in sight that might block the signal. On that residential road, I was able to get a maximum distance of 0.6 miles between the two GoTenna meshes, so a little bit farther than what I was getting in the urban environment. So based on my testing in both urban and residential environments, if you had 7 GoTenna meshes and each one of them was separated by half a mile distance, let's just assume that it's a straight shot, you would get a maximum distance of 3 miles between the two nodes leveraging all 6 hops. Just to give you a frame of reference, for those of you that live in Seattle, that's a little less of the distance between I-90 and the 520 bridge. Again, this is assuming that it's a straight shot with not a lot of hills, which it does have a lot of hills, so most likely it would be less than that. While it's not stellar, it's still pretty good. You would theoretically be able to set up a private network for off-grid communication in a section of a city, like Queen Anne, for example. Of course, you'd have to have a whole bunch of the GoTenna meshes, but theoretically, it's possible, especially if you had some nodes positioned in high-altitude areas, like the top of a building. There's a really cool website available at imeshu.gotennamesh.com. I'll provide a link in the description box. This is a network map of all of the GoTennas that are possibly in your area. It's not a live map and all the nodes are self-reported, but you could scroll into your specific neighborhood and you could see if there are any GoTenna devices in the area. Some of them are listed as GoTenna mobile, so they're paired with a smartphone. Other ones are listed as stationary relays, and then on occasion you may see one that's marked as a super relay. Usually the major cities have a lot more of the nodes that are available in that particular region, although you should check it out for yourself for your specific area.
All right, we're gonna do a little experiment with the GoTenna meshes and a drone. So we're gonna send this particular GoTenna mesh up 400 feet on the drone. We're gonna attach it to the drone, and then we're gonna use this one as a relay node. So this one's currently set to relay mode, and then I have these two paired with smartphones. So I'm gonna have this one down below where the drone is, and the drone's gonna be at 400 feet, this one's gonna be at the ground, and I'm gonna see how far away I could drive with this other one before I lose signal. So I'm hoping that I get a greater distance than what you would normally get in a residential or urban environment. We're in Tacoma, Washington right now, and I'm gonna be going down Stevens Street as far as I could go. So again, we're gonna have this drone up 400 feet, we're gonna have this one right below it 400 feet, and I'm gonna be driving away, and we'll see how far we could go away from this. So let's get started now with this test.
Doc Brown.
Plutonium powered.
All right, the drone's taken off. I'm gonna get in the car and see how far away I can get now. Let's get started. Prepper Hotline.
Hello, we're at 400.
You're at 400. Okay, we're coming up to 6th Ave.
Battery life's looking strong. I can see all the way to the water right now.
So I'm going to start going. I think I'm going to try to go to like North 10th to 12th around there.
Okay. Yeah, it's interesting. The road jogs and then it's pretty straight, you know, past 6th and beyond.
Okay.
I feel like I can see, yeah, I can feel see Stevens well into the 20s.
Wow,
you know.
Cool.
Okay, I got North 13th.
Oh, cool. Yeah, it says that I went through on mine too, one mesh node. Let me try 15th. Here's North 15th coming through. Looks like it went.
North 15th I got.
Sweet. It's working.
We got North 15th.
All right, let me go to 17th. That's pretty impressive. How's the drone battery?
Drone battery strong.
Cool.
North 21st.
Cool. Received.
Yeah, I see one mesh node.
Correct.
All right, I'm gonna go over to 76 station. Let's try that.
North 22nd received.
Cool. All right, so
I'm gonna double on back just to see if I can make it a 24th. Last one, and then I'm coming back. North 24th. I don't think it's gonna do it.
I think the rain is making it act strange. I'm going to bring it down, I think.
All right, cool.
You guys done?
Yeah, we just sent another one.
Yeah, we're done.
Okay.
Cool. Oh, it made it through.
There it is. North 25th redo.
All right, so we're making our way back. We ran out of drone battery again. We went about 34 blocks distance. We think it's a couple miles, so which is pretty good. It seemed to perform better when the car was actually facing towards the drone than if we're going away from it. So I'm going to put some stuff on the map so you can kind of see what kind of distance we're looking at. All right, that's going to do it for this particular segment of the GoTenna Mesh review, where we were using the drone. So again, we went about 34 blocks and we were using that drone as a relay point. So I was kind of envisioning this in a grid down scenario similar to the movie I Am Legend. If you guys remember watching that, Will Smith at noon every day, he would go send a radio broadcast and hoping to see if he could get anyone. I was kind of thinking the same thing could be used with the GoTenna Mesh and a drone, where they'd be able to provide signal to a wider network range of people in an emergency situation. So maybe they would be charging their drone using solar panels throughout the day and then be able to use that to basically provide coverage for almost an entire section of town. So that's kind of what I was envisioning here, and I think technically it would probably work. So we got about 34 blocks. So leave your comments below in the comment section regarding this particular segment of the GoTenna Mesh review.
Let's talk a little bit about some of the modding and the cool projects that people are doing with the GoTenna Mesh device. I played around with it a little bit for my particular testing, such as making a solar panel that's always connected to the device to be able to allow it to constantly charge when it's in relay mode. And I've had this on the top of the house for around 3 months now. So some projects that people are doing is using an Arduino to control the relay. When it senses enough light, it turns on the relay device. A lot of people are modding the devices to add an SMA adapter to add a more advanced antenna onto the device to help with the range. The people that do the modifications for the GoTenna meshes usually have two items that they really wish were added to this particular device, one being an SMA external antenna port to add a more advanced antenna on the device, and then the second having a more true relay mode with auto power on. So if it runs out of power and then eventually charges back up, it goes back into relay mode. During my testing, I set up a semi-permanent relay node on top of the house that was using solar for keeping the GoTenna Mesh charged. So I leveraged this little voltaic battery. It's a fairly expensive battery, but it has some really cool features. It comes with a solar panel, and voltaic makes a battery with always on feature, which is really nice. So it's always going to be powering on the device. It's not going to turn off by itself automatically. It also features pass-through charging, which is something you don't see for a lot of the anchor batteries, for example, where as you're charging this battery, it could charge a device. So I could always have a node relay charging on this device while this device is getting charged through solar. Modding these little GoTenna meshes is very difficult. I don't think GoTenna really wants people to mod them, but people are doing it anyway. There's an FCC issue that limits to 0.5 watts with an internal or fixed antenna, and that's why they don't have the SMA adapter to allow you to have a more advanced antenna on there. So people are just kind of hacking them up anyway. I've included a link in the description box to the GoTenna regulatory information that they have listed on their website. Let's talk about some of the cool things that people are doing with these GoTenna Mesh devices. In the book, Cascadia Fallen, Tahoma's Hammer, written by Austin Chambers, there's a scene in it where there's an off-grid emergency situation and some preppers are doing a recon mission where they're basically using these GoTenna meshes when the grid is down to do a recon mission to save someone. And it's a pretty exciting section of the story. It was really cool to see how they leveraged the GoTenna meshes for text-based communication. Another cool project that someone's done is called the MOAN, M-O-A-N, which stands for Mother of All Nodes. This particular person created a super node relay station that he's able to put on a building, for example, and adding an external antenna to the GoTenna mesh to extend the range of it. So it's a super relay node station that other people could use for communication within an urban environment. I've included a link in the description box. There's a company called Tourmaline Wireless, which is really leading the charge in leveraging these GoTenna meshes for expanded capabilities. So they've also created these super node relay stations that have a large antenna on them, are solar charged, are weather protected and everything. You're able to actually purchase them from the website. I'll include a link in the description box below. He also has some information on how to make one of these type of relay nodes that I did with the voltaic battery and the solar panel. Anyway, Tourmaline Wireless is really doing some cool things with the GoTenna meshes. Make sure you check them out. Let's talk now a little bit about the future of the GoTenna mesh. So this particular version of the GoTenna mesh is around 3 years old now to the time of the making of this video. There doesn't look to be any new hardware releases coming anytime soon. So GoTenna seems to be focusing a lot on the GoTenna Pro for public safety and military applications. And the software is focusing on cryptocurrency. So some of the competitors haven't caught up yet, like from Sonnet Labs. So GoTenna still has a head start on the competitors. They've also made an SDK available as well. Let's talk now about some of the things that I'd like to see improved upon with the GoTenna mesh. Number one, I'd like to see this available as a single unit so you don't have to buy two of them, to make it a little bit more affordable for people so they can include it in their bug out bags, for example. Also, I'd like to see it available in more discrete colors, so maybe all black where you don't have the bright green or bright blue or bright purple. For those of you that want to have it up in a tree, for example, or for discrete node relay positions, so maybe in black or camo would be really cool. And the other thing I'd like to see is to have the relay mode with always on. So if it runs out of power, for example, if it's not sunny enough for the solar panel to charge the device, as soon as it does become sunny again and it charges the device, if it's in relay mode, will just power back on into relay mode and continue being a node. Here's what I think would make it even cooler, and some of these are probably a little unrealistic. I would love to see a developer option of the GoTenna mesh where it's basically encouraging people to modify these things, kind of like an Arduino or a Raspberry Pi. So I do a lot of fun little projects with these particular devices for work type scenarios. I think a lot of people would like doing it for the GoTenna mesh as well. So being able to buy a developer board of the GoTenna mesh that it allows you to do some of these modifications that people are doing the hard way. So with that developer board, you would have an SMA external antenna port. I think it would encourage the developer community to create relay nodes everywhere to help with off-grid communication in a real emergency situation. I also think it would be a fun project for Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts to do for off-grid communication as well. That's going to do it for this video featuring the GoTenna Mesh Text and Locator Communicator. I hope that you guys enjoyed watching it. I know there was a lot covered in this video, so I've provided a lot of links in the description box below that you could check out for more information. I've also included a link to where you could purchase a pair of the GoTenna meshes on Amazon. So in summary, I really like these little devices for off-grid communication in a small, localized region. So it's not going to do you any good for long-range communication. If you want to communicate with your aunt in Alaska and you live in Seattle, you're not going to be able to use the GoTenna mesh for that type of communication. But you can use it for a small localized region. For example, a neighborhood watch group could really leverage these type of devices for off-grid communication. If everyone had one, you'd be able to leverage the mesh networking to communicate with one another. It's also really good if you had a small bug-out group, for example, and you're going to a bug-out location, as was described in the book Cascadia Fallen, Tahoma's Hammer. I could see it being really handy in that type of scenario where everyone has one of these included in their bug out bag and you're able to communicate with each other. And last, I think it'd be really good just for the secure financial transactions that you could do with these. Again, you have encrypted messages, no one could snoop through them. So a lot of people are using these for sending Bitcoin to each other. So for secure financial transactions with each other. So in an off-grid scenario, maybe you want to exchange Bitcoin or something like that. You could do that with the GoTenna meshes, which is really cool. So again, I provided a lot of information in the description box. Check that out. Leave your comments below in the comments section regarding this video, and I hope that you guys enjoyed watching this one. This one featured the GoTenna mesh. See you guys next time.